Well, good evening, everyone. Welcome to our monthly health condition workshop with BioTouch. Today we're going to talk about EMF sensitivities, and your guests and host today is my name's Paul.
And good evening, this is Bev.
So if you've never been to one of these, we hope you enjoy it. We're going to have a presentation, and then we're going to teach you the set of points that best works to take care of EMF sensitivities. If you want, as it said in the beginning and it's posted here, go to justtouch.com/workbook, and that will be the workbook that we work with at the second half of this workshop. So otherwise, we're just going to jump right into our guest speaker, Justin Franson. We actually had to pre-record it. He's a busy, busy man. So we'll pre-record it and we'll be back with you as soon as he's done. If you have any comments, any thoughts that you have, please put them in the comments. It's always nice to hear what people have to say, and there's links to his website on there also. So here we go. Hey everybody, we want to introduce you to Justin Franson. He's going to talk to us about EMF sensitivity. So Justin, just take it away. We're excited to hear what you have to say.
Paul, thank you so much for having me on. BioTouch is such an important part of facilitating people's healing journey, and EMF is one of the bigger stressors that we're dealing with. So let's go over some of the background of waveform technology and the difference between a native EMF waveform and the non-native ones. And when we start to break it down in the simplified language of a waves per second, everything starts to make sense really, really well for you. So what is an EMF? An EMF is electromagnetic field or frequency. Now, these fields can be either native or non-native. A native field would be a scalar wave that's unpolarized, that distributes equally in every direction. It's a framework for every living resonance in our entire universe. A non-native EMF is a one-directional waveform that's polarizing for our body, that disrupts our systems at tremendous levels by creating a vibration. And I'll go into all the effects of it in a little bit. But the main thing is when you're looking at understanding how our body interacts with these waveforms, the first question I love to ask everyone is, what is your environment? And when you can start to relate to your environment being mainly your atmosphere, is what I'll lean in on. And your atmosphere is comprised of it's air. And we're not supposed to see air. And the only time we equate to air being polluted to affecting our health is when we see it and you live in LA and it's all polluted. But what we're talking about is this invisible environment of the air. And how does that affect you? So these invisible waveforms of these one-directional polarizing non-native EMFs. And it's really simple. Our universe is based off of these scalar waves that distribute equally in every direction. So what that means is waves and particles travel through this air or ether or plasma. And that's how we're able to communicate with each other. So it's a really simple physics component of how our universe is made and how we're one with it and how we communicate with it. So the sun, you can see the light above and below my hand. That's an unpolarized light. If I were to drop a pebble in a pond, the splash, the waveform of the pond doesn't go in a straight line to the right or left or up or down. It distributes equally in every direction. That's the framework for every living resonance in our universe. Now, the one directional stuff, all the non-native EMFs, electricity, dirty electricity, and wireless, they're all one directional waveforms, or they don't work, Paul. That's how simple this is. So if they don't work, unless they're one directional, that means they're a polarizing charge that is a straight line. So it's basically like a laser beam going at you, essentially. And your body's like, what the heck is this? And so that's the foundational framework for the difference between how we're designed with these unpolarized resonances all around and how this non-native EMF stuff plays a role in affecting our health. And so what basically happens, Dr. Martin Paul talks about this. He's out of Washington State University. The voltage-gated calcium channels break down. Let's positive calcium into a negative cell. Well, let's dive into that word, voltage-gated. That's like a gateway for your volts, for your mitochondria, the powerhouse of your cell. When that gets disrupted, you have cell and DNA damage. That's a huge thing. So you have an oxidative stress that's affecting the mitochondria health of your cell. That's crazy. So when that happens, then you get your water destructures because they're broadcasting these bandwidths at 2.45 gigahertz or 2.45 billion waves per second, same bandwidth that'll destructure water. So not only are we messing with our mitochondria, we're creating oxidative stress, we're destructuring our water, we're calcifying our pineal glands, we're disrupting our hormone level, our sleep, our body, the fundamental power centers of our body at the cellular level. That's what this EMF stuff does just right out of the gate. And it does it even with low-level EMF. So low-level EMF would be a milligauss of 50 to 60 waves per second. Dirty electricity would be 4,000 to 100,000 waves per second. Wireless would be 50 million to several billion waves per second. 5G is 60 to 90 billion waves per second. So let's talk about this wave per second. What is the Schumann resonance of the Earth? That is called the healing pulse of the Earth at 7.83 waves per second. So the Schumann resonance is 7.83 waves per second, and the cell phones are 2.45 billion waves per second. So that's a 10-0 difference between the speed of a one-directional waveform and how the Earth's designed to facilitate healing us. And then 5G is 60 to 90, so that's even faster. Now, I know a lot of people are familiar with the brainwave states. When you're in a delta or theta brainwave states, that's a sleep and restorative state. So a delta is a really deep sleep, a 1 or below 1 to 4 hertz or waves per second. A theta is 4 to 8 hertz or waves per second. When our athletes, so I founded athleticism.com 25 years ago, work with professional athletes, all these sports. When our athletes are in the flow and in the zone, they're revving at 8 to 13 hertz or waves per second. That's how low and slow they're connecting with that infinite flow of the universe, that universal rhythm. Okay, that's really close to the Schumann resonance at 7.83 hertz. So when we're sleep revving and optimizing in the flow state, we're at a very low and slow waveform. And we're connected to this universe in such a way, and that's what facilitates us. Because there's this living collective intelligence matrix that we're all one, and it's all connected through these scalar waves. And we have our own bioenergetic processes inside our body. And that's how we have our own electrical systems of each of us individually. And people will call it through thermal dynamics, where our interplay with our bodies between matter and radiation, or a piezoelectric effect where energy of one combats and meets the energy of another. That's how our grounding bags really work. But these are scientific proven processes that how our body works as far as we're electromagnetic beings. And as Bruce Lipton will share, the chi, our life force in our biofield, is primary. The chemistry in our body would be secondary. So we got to get this life force amped up. But if something comes in and starts to penetrate that life force and chips away at it, it's going to mess with the mitochondria in your body and in turn disrupt a lot of systems. So from the scientific physics biology standpoint, that's really how we're one with the universe and how we work in this interplay between us and these non-native waveforms. So the simple part is to understand, what is the stressor? Well, the stressors are all electricity, dirty electricity, meaning bad wiring, and then wireless signals. So electricity, any outlet or any electrical device, dirty electricity would be dim switches, trying to keep the level of light that you're requesting. That's a huge effort for our electrical grid in our house to do that. And it causes lots of static in the line. You'll see dirty electricity occur often with people with solar panels on their home. Unfortunately, as much as everyone wants to get off the grid, when they purchase solar, they're still on the grid for any overage, but they're causing lots of dirty electricity. They haven't figured out how to ground out that solar. So when you would plug a Stetzer electric meter in, it would normalize it to the meter read 50 or below. Most homes with solar are 800 to 1600 of what the meter reads, which is amps to volts reading. So really, really disruptive speed of a waveform. Now you get into wireless stuff. Well, obviously Ring, Nest, AOC units, all your routers, Alexas, any wireless device, any smart device, those are all, they call them smart because they're always broadcasting. They're looking for you to talk to it. And they're looking and they're communicating back to a station to share your information. And smart meters are one and the same. They operate as a two-way router. The smart meter is an automated gas and electric meter that's on your home that pings into your home every 7 to 15 seconds and then sends that information out to a substation. So opt out of those smart meters because it's like having a cell tower on your home. Real simple way to quiet the resonance of your home down. These, once we identify what these stressors are, then, and I like to get meters. You can get a milligauss meter, a Stetzer electric meter for dirty electricity, or an acoustometer, one directional EMF reader for the wireless signals. And all three of those meters run you about, you know, $600-$700, maybe the most. But when you point wireless meter at a cell phone, it's super quiet. When you look at it, it's quiet. When you point the meter at it, the meter starts screaming. The screaming that the meter does is the sound that our body hears and our nerves feel. It's that vibration that affects us and plants and pets and our environment because it dehydrates it. But most people can't hear that bandwidth. But we're always inundated on it. So I equate that to, it's a radio station. If you're listening to radio and you're turning it in between the main stations, that static that you're going to hear is what our body's hearing all the time. And so that's that vibration, that disruptive feel that we get. I can hear it really well when I go underwater. So I'm a big waterman. I live in Laguna Beach, California, and I body surf and surf. And when I jump in the water and go underwater, I can hear if the dolphins are in our cove or whales. And then I can also hear if there's an electric foil board going. And that electric foil board is probably the worst noise pollution you can ever hear. It's just super loud and annoying. And so anyhow, you can hear some of these bandwidths underwater way clearer than just through the air, which is interesting. So meter, learn the difference between the interplay with how we work with the universe. Grab some meters to start to quantify it, because those meters measure the speed of a wavelength. That's what they're designed to do. So this isn't woo-woo stuff. There's actual meters that can meter the exact speed of these wavelengths. And when I point my one-directional wireless acoustometer at the cell phone, it can't read the level of the cell phone emission. It's not strong enough. They're making these cell phones so strong that my meter meters out. So how do we know what signal strength telecom's really rolling out? There's no oversight on these companies, and they're telecom. They're not health companies. They don't care about our health. So we don't really know what bandwidths are rolling out. So get rid of this stuff, get the stressor out of life. The reason I came up with EMFrocks.com and our grounding bags that are sold through doctor clinics all around the country is because I saw athletes breaking down from wearable technology. One of the strongest, fittest endurance athletes came through wearing a smartwatch. His whole arm went weak. I said, hey, take that radiation off your wrist. And he's like, I don't feel pain on my wrist anymore. And then his arm started to heal and the strength restored. It was pretty quick. So unbelievable stuff. So that's when I'm like, okay, I have to look to nature to solve this resonance challenge, because nobody does it better than Mother Nature. Any other man-made product attempting to keep up with nature is a genetically modified field. That's like eating genetically modified food. Hey, let me make a resonance to overpower the other man-made resonance. That doesn't make sense to me. Let's look to nature and see how much of Mother Nature we can bring into our home. We hand mine crystals. That's what's inside here. She has these healing pulse of the earth in here with moisture and magnetic properties. So shungite, amethyst, black tourmaline, all those only have magnetic resonances. Ours has the moisture with the magnetic. The combination between the two makes these exponentially stronger for facilitating healing, creating a balance, a harmony, a coherence between us and non-native EMFs. What it does is it actually takes a one-directional waveform and converts it. It's called physics. We can coexist with this stuff. You can convert a one-directional waveform into something that's unpolarized. That's what Mother Nature is designed to do. That's why we look to her resonance. Now, right now, there's about 20% of the population here in the U.S. that's EMF sensitive. So BioTouch is one of the most important things you could do, is to start to build that life force up. Now, what I want to encourage everyone to do to complement your BioTouch efforts is to detox, detox, detox. And you have to do an external detox, flush your biofield. So we get stuck EMF toxicity in our energy field, okay? This energy field ironically goes out about 6 feet. We get charged, our body battery kind of works from, we get a negative charge from the earth and we pull those electrons. We get a positive charge from the unpolarized light of the sun. We breathe in minerals and then hopefully we get it from our food and we drink this incredible water for the conductivity. That's how our body battery works. Now, that's when that resonance is really strong. You're feeling great. If there go by a cell tower, you can get a lot of stuck EMF in your biofield. So use the grounding bags. And I would encourage everyone to do this before you do BioTouch, to flush the toxicity out. We use a tapping protocol. You tap on the bag and that'll 10x your energy right away. Then your eyes, your teeth, your thymus, your large intestine are the four primary areas that get decharged. So tap on the bag with one hand. Your other hand, you're gonna cover each of those areas one at a time. So cover your eyes and tap and breathe. And then your teeth. And then your upper chest, your thymus. This is the electrical system for your body. So if your energy's off, you're dealing with mold, microtoxins, Lyme, parasites, fungus, candida, recharge your electrical system. That will help. And then hand below your belly button, your intestine area, tap and breathe. Once you do that, what you've done is you've cleared your biofield, you've recharged your body battery. Now, when you go to do BioTouch, you're gonna have exceptional results, even far surpassing what it could do. Because if your polarity's not turned back on, any treatment's gonna be a little tougher to get kicked in. And it's really tough to heal when you're decharged. So let's recharge our body battery through our grounding bags. It's the most effective way to do it. We sell them through doctor clinics all around the country. These are the leading natural EMF protection products sold on the marketplace. And then we have minis for your pocket, purse, or backpack for on-the-go protection. So we want to coexist with this stuff. The last point I want to make is sitting on a battery, which would be an electric car, is probably one of the worst things you can do for yourself. It's going to shut down your hormone system. It's going to give you 15%, it's going to be 18% lower testosterone. Okay. And then you're going to have all the cognitive challenges of lack of focus, memory, anxiety, fatigue, stress, headaches, ringing in the ears, all the EMF challenges that are going to go along with it. And then there's going to be that lack of fertility coming into play as well. So let's get this stuff out of our world and allow us to sleep. And the sleep is probably one of the biggest things because it messes with our pineal gland, calcifies it, and then it messes with your melatonin. So you don't get in these deep restorative states, because basically if you have your phone next to you or a Wi-Fi in your room or in your house on, it's always broadcasting at, you know, about 2.45 billion waves per second. So if you're sleeping at 1 to 8, your brain tries to figure out what's pinging it. What's that bandwidth that's pinging it? And it takes you out of your deep restorative sleep. So Dr. Rodney White out of Nebraska, he just did a sleep test. The grounding bags dropped him into a deeper sleep from 45 minutes into 100 minutes for 2 months straight. He's never, ever tested a product that brought him into 100 minutes for 2 months straight, until he met our grounding bags. Dr. Bear Lando, alphavedic.com, A-L-F-A-V-E-D-I-C, another incredible resource. He did a waveform test. He tested the chi of these people. And he has these dual impedance antennas. They measure any distortion in your chi. So if your energy's off this way, he'll say, oh, it's left side, it's this going on. He'll tell you exactly what's wrong with you, because the chemistry is the secondary effect. So he thinks it's way better than blood work. And what he'll do is the grounding bags clinically passively treated up to 91% of the markers off. So we have doctors doing crazy studies. You'll sleep 3 to 50% deeper, or with Rodney White over 50%. And you guys, you'll be able to coexist with this non-native EMF and not have to worry about the bigs of cancer, suicide, diabetes, Alzheimer's, and cardiovascular, and the lack of fertility. So I really encourage you to check out our grounding bags. The biggest topic next to this, which I've dove in learning about, is about data harvesting and our security from tech. These phones are designed to track and trace and listen and send all that information to AI in record speeds. So when you could put your phone in a Faraday bag, turn off all the tracking devices on all your apps, you're gonna slow down this aggregation of information and protect your health and security and your privacy and get out of the meta universe that they want you to get in. And the big thing is with that, these things aren't our security blanket, okay? These cell phones, they're not. They are a weapon, and we're having them in our hands and our laps. So guys, get grounded by nature, because that's your nature. Get outside, go touch a tree, jump into a body of water, okay? Get in, have a picnic, get into nature, because that's how you're gonna start to heal. And that's what's gonna recharge your body battery. Until you really recharge and get outside and become one with nature, it's gonna be tough to heal very quickly, or if at all. Mm-hmm. And use our grounding bags when you're inside, because we live in electrical boxes, essentially. All our homes have electricity in it. So ground out that electricity, put one of these on your bed, you'll sleep way better. Put 5 together, clear 2,000 square feet, and 7 if you have solar, 7 if you drive an electric car. We can coexist with this stuff, but we just have to get grounded by nature. So Thank you guys so much for jumping on. Check us out, emfrocks.com and our grounding bags. Get grounded by nature because that is your nature. Thank you so much.
Hey, Justin, I tell you, I'm overloaded with your information. I need to go ground. But hey, we appreciate it. You know, I'll tell you something. When I first started BioTouch, I was reading Dr. Robert Becker. That was back in the 80s, and he was just starting to tell us about just the little radios that we had on our things and springs and, you know, electromagnetic pollution and stuff. And I always thought back then when I started BioTouch, you know, there's all this stuff out there, but I'm really grateful I have BioTouch. And you just twisted that in about we can coexist here. And your rocks, you know, the grounding, the getting outside, the hugging a tree, things like BioTouch, yeah, that was inspirational to me. I appreciate your presentation that we can coexist. We don't have to be afraid of this stuff because that just creates another loop. So
definitely. There's a book called The Invisible Rainbow by Arthur Furstenberg, and he categorized the history of electricity and life and directly correlates every major rollout of radio waves or electricity or satellites to a lot of people getting sick. So 1918, the Spanish flu, they put out radio waves. And then, you know, obviously the last few years they put out 5G. So there's a huge correlation between us and our environment. So let's learn from that and then get grounded through the process and use some incredible healing modalities like BioTouch and nature to help facilitate us really thriving.
All right. Well, we appreciate your presentation, and we'll let people get in touch with you personally because you have some good information. Thanks, Justin.
Thank
you. Woo-wee!
Oh, man. My head's about ready to...
I know. This is the second time, third time I've listened to it, and I'm just, like, spinning, trying to take notes, but...
Well, you know, I guess somebody had to say it, because remember when the 5G first came out, there was a big controversy about, oh, it's not, it's harmless, and the other camp going, oh my gosh, no, it's not, it is this and this and this. So there's a lot of people becoming aware of what Justin is talking about anyway,
right?
You know,
yeah.
Our job is to make them become aware of BioTouch in your life.
That's right. So we're gonna pick up on this on our Monday show because we have some great information. I got turned on to electromagnetic pollution back in the 80s when all they had was clock radios.
I know. Hair blowers and stuff.
Hair blowers, right.
The
springs in your box springs, you know.
That's and crazy. So, I mean,
crazy, crazy stuff. But we have BioTouch to help. And as Justin said, you know, if you have the rocks and you want to do the cleansing thing first and then BioTouch, or if all you have is BioTouch, we're going to share with you the basic sets of points that are going to help you coexist. I love that word. Coexist with this electromagnetic frequency pollution. You're not going to get rid of it, but we have BioTouch to help us live with it.
Yeah, so we're going to part of our world.
Yeah,
part of our world.
We're going to turn to Bev here, who's going to teach us the points, and I'm going to play Mr. Techie here in the background. So
okay. So there's a few things that we go over every workshop because we're hoping that there are always new people showing up and also people who haven't heard about BioTouch. So we'll quickly go over as an introduction. So if you have the workbook, or when you get it later, if you want to do that, notice that the first page is always the condition. So we put together an overview of that, and that's always that first page. So let's start moving on to actually talking about these major bullets of BioTouch. So on page 6, we see it says, what is BioTouch? For those of you who are not familiar with BioTouch, this is just going to give you a little bit of basic information to really see how easy it is, how simple it is. So BioTouch is a hands-on. It's two fingers of the hands touching the skin. Two fingers touching the skin very lightly, like a butterfly. And basically, BioTouch can address any condition that the body can manifest. So let's move on to the first bullet, which says BioTouch is easy to learn. Even children can learn and practice it effectively. That's a key word right there. So the minute that you learn BioTouch, you can turn around and practice it with someone, and immediately you are effective for them, which is one of the unique aspects of BioTouch. Even children can learn it, and that's true. We've even had children become certified. It's a simple technique, and it's very effective the first time you use it. Second bullet, BioTouch is a complement to any healthcare program. Kind of like what Justin was talking about, all these suggestions he has, BioTouch is only going to enhance whatever healthcare program you are working with, whether it's a special diet, maybe you're using other modalities, going to other practitioners, you're under a doctor's care, you're on specific medications, whatever the case may be, BioTouch is only going to enhance that healing journey that you're on. So we have realized it's not just a complement. BioTouch is what we call holistic and integrative. It actually starts to affect not just the body, but over time, other parts of our cells that are held within that body. So the next bullet, BioTouch has no levels of ability. Everyone is effective the first time. We already talked about that, but it's worth mentioning again, because just learning, you don't have to take the training. You have to go to, there's no special preparation, no belief. We have no philosophy. We have no belief system. You do not have to have that either in order to be effective and help another person. You don't have to prepare the space. You don't have to try to, whatever people are saying, I have to help myself against the negativity of the other person. There's nothing like that. There's no barriers in BioTouch. Nothing specific that gets in the way. It's one human being touching another human being because they care. It brings in compassion and the ability to just be present with another person. That's really all that's required to practice BioTouch. So let's just quickly go over the process when you begin. When to wash your hands before you begin to work with anyone. First, wash your hands. BioTouch is one person touching another person lightly on the skin. And most everyone says, can you do BioTouch on yourself? Our pat answer is, if you can reach those specific points in any set, why not? However, just by definition, that is not BioTouch. You're just touching points on the body. Is it effective? We don't know. Why not? But if you want to practice BioTouch, it requires two people. So one person touching another. You always want to begin with what the very first step we're going to teach you, called the greeting. You always want to use the first two fingers of each hand. You're going to touch lightly like a butterfly on the skin. And when you do the points of each set, as you will see in the videos we're going to show you, you're going to want to hold those points 6 to 8 seconds. So we say that BioTouch can be practiced anytime, anywhere, with anyone. And that's very true. Very true. You once you learn this technique or parts of it, whatever you want to, you will have a tool that you can help others with at any time. Okay, so the next page, it says at the top, terms used in this manual, and we won't go over those tonight, but we always like to bring to your attention those first two bullets, because this is the relationship in BioTouch. You have an associate, which is the person that is performing BioTouch. And what's interesting is we look at the dictionary description of what an associate, and two things pop up. One is one often in the company with another, implying an intimacy or an equality. And the second one, one having an interest in common with another. That is one of the biggest points, I think, of BioTouch. It brings, and this relationship brings in an equality between the associate, the one performing BioTouch, and the recipient who is benefiting, the beneficiary of the technique. So you have the associate and the recipient. But what you will find, as we all have, it is a relationship of healing in equality. Both the recipient and the associate get something from that. It's not one person working on another. It's two people working together. That's a very subtle point, but very important when you are practicing something like BioTouch. So we're going to move on to the first set, as I mentioned before, called the greeting. This is, you always want to perform the greeting before you go anywhere else and work with any other parts of the body. Even if you do just the greeting, you're going to start something. That much we know. So it's always, the only thing that is a little bit different with the greeting is you want to use, as you will see in the video, want to always use your dominant hand and only one hand. Everything else, it doesn't matter, but both hands are involved. So Paul, did you want to bring up anything?
Let me just bring up something here. If you'll notice, page one of each set is a drawing that we just showed you with the number of where the points are. The second page of each set has a photograph, as you can see here, of somebody doing the particular points, and you can see those two fingers. Then there's a description of where the points are in very layman kind of terms. And at the bottom of each of those pages, you'll see there it says, click here to watch video. And that will be what we're going to show here in how to proceed in doing the points. That makes sense?
Yep.
Okay.
Thank you.
So let's go ahead and show that greeting, yeah?
Yep.
Always performed at the beginning of each session. It's the only set that uses one hand and the only set that indicates which hand to use. The greeting is performed with the dominant hand. If you are right-handed, use your right hand. If you are left-handed, use your left hand. The greeting is made by touching at point one, which is in the fleshy area just below the bottom of the breastbone or sternum. Hold this point for 6 to 8 seconds. Then, with the same two fingers, touch point two on the back. To find point two, look for the big bone at the base of the neck. From here, move 1 to 1.5 inches to the left. This is point two. Hold this point for 6 to 8 seconds. More than one associate may work with a recipient, provided that all of the associates perform the greeting. If the associate or the recipient leaves the session, or if someone who hasn't done the greeting touches either the recipient or the associate, the greeting must be reestablished. Then the session may proceed from where it was interrupted.
Okay, so now you've done the greeting, you're ready to go to the other sets of points. So the first one here is the head set, which is anything, it deals with anything having to do with the brain. And when I was listening to Justin's presentation, he was talking about the delta and theta brain waves that put us into a slow and low and into sleep. And so the head is always, as we know, a lot of people use the headset for sleep problems, insomnias, anything like that because of the chemicals and hormones it secretes. But Paul, I was just thinking about, you know, we've all had doing the headset on somebody who's like, I guess, passed out.
Right.
Remember? And now that makes sense because the brain waves doing biotouch get so down and slow that it's almost like the body can't handle it and they go bye-bye.
Interesting. You're right.
Yeah. So anyway, let's go ahead and watch the video and you can see someone doing the headset.
The headset can be used to address conditions related to the brain. There are four steps in this set. In step one, use Thru-Fire to touch points A and A. Point A on the back of the head is in the center of the neck at the base of the skull. Point A on the front of the head is at the center of the forehead where the forehead begins to curve to the crown. Step 2 is performed in crossfire with the fingers of each hand touching on opposite sides of the head. Hold at X, which is in the indentation beside the neck muscle at the base of the skull. It is the same as point 1 of the back set. On the opposite side of the head, touch points 1 through 5. Points 1, 2, and 3 are on the ridge line formed where the skull curves up toward the crown. Point 1 is above the outside corner of the eye on the ridge. Point 2 is above the front of the ear on the ridge. Point 3 is above the back of the ear on the ridge. To locate point 4, move down the head toward the base of the skull to a horizontal indentation approximately 1/3 of the way down from the top of the ear and 1 to 1.5 inches behind the back edge of the ear. Point 5 is opposite hold point X at the base of the skull. Point 5 now becomes the new hold point as points 1 through 5 are touched on the opposite side of the head. In crossfire, touch point 1 above the outside corner of the eye on the ridge, point 2 above the front of the ear on the ridge, point 3 is above the back of the ear on the ridge. Point 4 is a horizontal indentation approximately 1/3 of the way down from the top of the ear and 1 to 1.5 inches behind the back edge of the ear. And point 5 is opposite hold point X at the base of the skull. Step 3 is performed in matching fire, touching points 1 and 1. Two and two, three and three, four and four, five and five. Finally, in step 4, place the open palms of both hands on the head covering points 1 through 3. Be careful, don't let your hands touch each other.
Okay, so the headset, great one. The next one that we recommend is the neck set. Very simple. But it's important because that if you look at the page, you'll see that diamond. That is what we call the big bone and the source of the nerves that go into the head, into the brain, and also in the neck and down into the arms and hands. So this is just probably a really good set to use in conjunction with the headset. It really addresses all of those nerve paths.
Yeah, so it sort of gives that, a lot of people who have EMF sensitivities, they sort of feel like their body's in one place and their head's in another.
Yeah.
And that whole neck is all locked up and it's not getting the communication. So it's a very simple, effective approach to help with that.
Absolutely. So let's go ahead and watch the video.
The neck set is used for addressing most headaches, neck pains, and soreness of the upper back. These points are performed in matching fire on the large muscles that run along the back of the neck. Points 1 and 1 are halfway down the neck on the side of the large muscles. Points 2 and 2 are at the top of the neck on the side of the large muscles at the base of the skull. Points 3 and 3 are at the bottom of the neck on the side of the large muscles. As with any set, you may repeat the points as many times as you like. These points may be touched in any order, such as touching points 2, then points 1, and finally points 3.
Okay. The next set is the stress and anxiety. And Justin was talking about the fact that we are recipients of electrical stressors constantly, as if we didn't have enough stressors in our life. Now and these are way beyond or below the threshold of our awareness sometimes. So this set is really important because when we are feeling anything that happens emotionally or mentally for us, sometimes does have physical manifestations. So the stress set is always a good one to use. It's very simple, as you're going to see, but it's very effective to help with that stress and anxiety that the body is going to be under every day. All the time. So let's go ahead and watch the video.
The stress set may be used to address any manifestation of physical, emotional, or mental stress, as well as anxiety and shingles. Hold at X, which is in the fleshy area just below the bottom of the breastbone. It is the same as greeting point 1. Then with the other hand, touch points 1 and 2, which are the same points as in the heart set. These points are found by imagining a line running from the notch at the top of the breastbone to a place on the left breast where the nipple would be on a youth. Divide this imaginary line into thirds. Point 1 is at the top of the first third. Point 2 is at the top of the second third. These points may be touched repeatedly, and remember to touch each point for at least 6 to 8 seconds.
So the last set we want to teach is the metabolism set, and this is kind of a balance, helps the body in this balancing. Justin was talking about bringing the body back into a wholesomeness and a natural state, because the metabolism set helps the body to, it's assimilating what it needs, getting rid of what it doesn't need. And of course, it doesn't need a lot of what he was talking about tonight. So this is a great set to use in conjunction with everything else that we've taught you tonight. Let's go ahead and watch the video.
The metabolism set can be used to help the body assimilate what it needs and eliminate what it doesn't need. The metabolism set has two steps. Step 1 involves touching points in matching fire along the large muscles on the front of the neck. Points 1 and 1 are located above the collarbone in the soft indentations on both sides of the notch at the top of the breastbone. Points 2 and 2 are halfway up the neck on the front of the large muscles. Points 3 and 3 are at the top of the neck on the front of the large muscles. The second step involves holding a point on the front of the body and touching points next to the spine on the back. Hold point X on the front of the body is on a line directly between where the nipples would be on a youth and is 1 to 2 inches to the left of the breastbone. Another way to find X is 1/3 of the way up the breastbone from greeting point 1 and 1 to 2 inches to the left of the breastbone. The points on the back are located next to the spine, forming a rectangle around the breakover point. The breakover point is where the bottom of the rib cage joins the spine and can be found by imagining a line directly through the body from greeting point 1. To perform step 2, find hold point X on the front of the body and touch points 1 through 4 on the back. Point 1 is approximately 1 to 2 inches up from the breakover point on the left spine muscle. Point 2 is directly across from point 1 on the right spine muscle. Point 3 is 2 to 3 inches below the breakover point on the right spine muscle. Point 4 is used to address blood sugar problems and is added to the other metabolism points when needed. It is located across from point 3 on the left spine muscle.
And there you go.
Wow. Can I just say this in closing before you get and give them some information? Justin said in the beginning that our bodies are being disrupted at the cellular level by all of this technology. And for me, that is the one of the primary reasons for us all to be using BioTouch, because he mentioned Dr. Bruce Lipton, who is a cellular biologist. And what did he say? You can change the story with love. That's what BioTouch is here to do. It communicates. That's why this touch on the skin is so important. Not through the clothes, not over the body, not touching each other on the skin, because it speaks at the cellular level. That was a real wonderful thing for me.
And it helps us remember we are all one on this planet. At that cellular level. This is not some philosophical thing you have to believe in.
Right.
We're talking at a cellular level. Go hug a tree, walk on the earth, do BioTouch, do the rocks. Start to coexist with these problems that we have on the planet. And we coexist with love. It's time. So go to justtouch.com if you want more information. We hope this workshop has helped you. We have many, many other workshops that you can find on our website and download the manuals with them. And we love doing this. Thank you, Bev, for helping us learn the points.
Thank you, Paul.
And we'll see
you
all.
Thank you, everyone.
See you all at the next workshop.